Are your text messages truly private? You probably already know that they have privacy issues, but that's about to change. This is probably one of the biggest updates I've seen in a long time regarding end-to-end encryption because Apple has committed to a new open standard for RCS. And we'll talk about what RCS is if you've never heard of it, and what this end-to-end encryption standard looks like, what it means for you, and why this is actually super significant. Listen up because it's going to impact literally everybody watching. Very, very brief overview of RCS if you've never heard of it before. You probably are very familiar with texting people, low quality images, short character limits. RCS actually aims to make this a lot better, and people did probably start noticing that on their iPhones, the green bubbles, with some other Android users, they were starting to finally get typing indicators, reactions, all the like modern features you expect. RCS supports rich images, so higher quality images and videos, supports read receipts, typing indicators, group chat improvements. It helps bridge the blue versus green bubble issue. And it's a good reminder that SMS, the legacy technology, is extremely outdated. So RCS is like SMS 2.0. A big misconception about RCS that I fell victim to as well as it was first rolling out was being under the impression that it was more secure than SMS. The reality is there was nothing built into the RCS standard that would change much of your security at all. And it definitely did not have end-to-end encryption so that all of your messages just stayed between you and the other person, and your cell company or anyone else couldn't read them. This is why we talk about end-to-end encrypted messengers here, why they're important, because you deserve basic security. Another reason why this was a misconception is because Google did implement RCS with end-to-end encryption. However, this is very important to outline and is important for this whole video because Google's implementation was their own implementation. Only if you use Google Messages, so in their ecosystem, they enabled end-to-end encryption separately from the standard, but it was never put into the standard, which is why we've never seen RCS with end-to-end encryption. For some reason, no one's talking about the spec and diving deep into it. I haven't seen a single news article really cover the spec and what it can mean for all of you. I'm kind of gonna like speedball through some of the notes that they have here, and then I'll kind of paint the full picture. So first, SMS messages are not going to have end-to-end encryption. So if you were expecting SMS to gain this technology, not gonna happen. This is only for RCS. Another important note here, which I think is really cool, is that if the sender and recipient, so if both people have enabled end-to-end encryption and the message can't be delivered for whatever reason, RCS service will not apply NFS. NFS stands for network fallback to SMS. So really cool, because what we've sometimes seen in the past with like iMessage, if you, there was a feature, and I think there still is a feature, where if the iMessage doesn't go through, it'll fall back to SMS, which might be good for compatibility and making sure the text still goes through, but it's not very good for security because you want to make sure it's always end-to-end encrypted. So they are baking it in to the spec that it should not fall back to SMS. This says the same exact thing, support for CFS, which is client fallback to SMS. So this is pretty much instructing both the network and the client to not fall back to SMS and stay using end-to-end encryption if both users enabled end-to-end encryption. This note here says the RCS client, so if you download an app that supports RCS, it will only send an encrypted message when the recipient's RCS client has enabled end-to-end encryption as well. It's a good reminder that you need two people to use end-to-end encryption. And so this just quickly says that your client will only send an encrypted message to someone else if they also have a client that has enabled end-to-end encryption. It's pretty cool that built into the spec, it does say the RCS client can ask the user to take an action, like to update the client in order to support end-to-end encryption. So it gives people leeway to pretty much bug users to enable this, which I think is super awesome. This is probably, I think, the most interesting thing of the standard because it's so open-ended and it could actually be bad. An RCS client having end-to-end encryption shared shall implement techniques to detect suspicious messages or conversations. Obviously, this can mean a lot of things, and it even says here the implementation details are left to the client. If end-to-end encryption is enabled for the conversation, RCS messages content cannot be checked for spam or fraud, so it's important to check them on the client to protect users. And as RCS client having end-to-end encryption enabled shall inform users of any suspicious messages or conversations that it detected. I don't know what this is going to look like yet. My guess is that, you know, you're going to have services like Signal that do have some kind of spam or fraud detection, but it's normally through things like Google CAPTCHA and through the phone number requirement, etc. Whereas on the Google end, it's kind of done through a Google account and by just collecting a ton of data about you and trying to figure out if you're being legitimate. So I'm sure this is going to vary a ton, and this open-endedness is both kind of a blessing and a curse. I personally wish they included some privacy wording here to pretty much like hint at the fact that this could be misinterpreted for some pretty nasty stuff for privacy. So it would have been cool if they put a note that was like, an RCS client should implement like proper privacy standards to ensure like, you know, customer data is kept safe. So really interesting bit. So something to watch out for when eventually you might have to pick an RCS end-to-end encrypted client. For any of you who think that laws don't matter, listen up, because RCS clients shall enable end-to-end encryption by default unless expressly prohibited by local regulations. And this is a question I've seen, which is group chats support for end-to-end encryption. So we might actually still see end-to-end encrypted group chats as well, which is super exciting. As for how to like trigger this or make it happen, when the RCS clients of all group chat participants have enabled end-to-end encryption, the RCS clients should encrypt and decrypt group chat subject and icon. It might sound hard to get everybody to use end-to-end encryption, but luckily, for better or for worse, you can actually isolate who's a problem, because it's going to be built into the spec that if you're adding a user that doesn't have encryption, it will notify you that it will make the entire group no longer end-to-end encrypted. So it's cool that there's kind of these notifications built into the spec. So regardless of whatever client you use, you're going to have some transparency over this stuff. Kind of a given, but it's worth mentioning that file transfers will also now support end-to-end encryption, which might be obvious. I mean, if the messages are encrypted and you upload something to it, that would be encrypted as well. But yes, it is built into the spec and they detail how to implement this securely. And it actually encrypts the file name, file content type, and the file content itself, which is pretty good. And from what I can tell, actually goes slightly above and beyond what they need to do for just a bare minimum. So pretty cool stuff. But I want to really outline why this is huge, because it is huge. And let's talk about why. One, increased privacy for all. It doesn't matter if you're going to use an iPhone, it doesn't matter if you're going to use potentially even an iPad or an Android device, it doesn't matter what client you're going to use. Ideally, you're going to get basic end-to-end encryption, and it's going to be a massive step up from SMS. So big wins for everybody. This raises the bar. The other one is that this is standardized. You know, Google did their own thing with Google Messages, but it was never really intended to be utilized on other platforms or clients, as far as I can tell, whereas this is an open standard built into what everybody's going to need to do. So anyone who wants to build an RCS client, which for the record, there aren't that many out there, so I hope to see more, again, touching on that soon, we'll have to use this common encryption standard, which is super awesome. I also do still want to outline that this improves the user experience. This isn't like your, you know, historical legacy green text bubbles on the iPhone with just better security. You're still getting the benefits and the usability improvements of RCS, but you're also getting security on top of it. It's kind of the best of both worlds. And just to top it off, like, this is the adoption that we're looking for. Like, we want more people to use encryption. It keeps you safe. It keeps your messages safe. And normalizing encryption makes encryption more normal. Like, it means that it's less easy to be attacked. It means that it's more of a normal, ubiquitous type of thing. And this is just phenomenal for everybody, regardless if you're going to use RCS or not, or you're going to use something better. And I'll touch on what's better. Now, some drawbacks and considerations, because this is not perfect. And I definitely want to talk about some of the things that I'm looking at. One, there are probably still going to be some metadata concerns. I don't know what those are yet completely. You know, we did see that there is some encryption for some of the things, and they do use RCS aliases. Like, those are encrypted if you have end-to-end encryption. And so there are some considerations, I think, for metadata, but it's just not going to be as well done as something like Signal or some of the other messengers that we talk about in our resources on our website. You can check out our site in the description. I also think kind of a drawback, not one that I don't think should exist, it's just inevitable, is it actually is going to make it a little bit harder to get people you know onto better services. Like, I think Signal's a good example here. Like, Signal's extremely usable, it has some super cool features, and it is extremely secure and extremely private. Previously, if people are using SMS, I just go, hey, yeah, SMS sucks, doesn't it? Let's move to Signal. But now that, like, potentially it'll slowly become RCS, and a lot of people with RCS will have similar features to Signal with the security, I'm going to get some more pushback. And it's going to be like, well, I mean, why don't we just use RCS? Like, it seems it's encrypted and it's got features. Like, why do I have to use Signal? So I think that this will make it slightly harder for some of us to move people to potentially better options, and that just means we need to evolve our talking points and be able to still educate ourselves and others about the issues that RCS probably will still have. So something to just keep on your radar and to start thinking about before this becomes an issue. My third drawback kind of has to do with the group chat feature, and it's a good reminder that standards and specs like this only matter if it's actually utilized by people. And for it to be utilized by people, we need clients that actually support the tech. So I hope that that happens sooner rather than later. Because otherwise, you know, what's the point of having end-to-end encrypted group chats if you can never get four people that actually use RCS with end-to-end encryption to use it? Because you need everyone to use it. Now, some questions that I've already seen from people or things that I hypothesize you guys might ask me in the comments that I want to clear up right now. So the first one is, oh, this is Apple just trying to lock people into their ecosystem. Actually, not this time, weird to say. This is an open standard. And so as we covered in this document, this is something that any and hopefully all RCS clients eventually will be implementing. So this is open. Another question is, will I have access to this in my messenger? I don't know. That's kind of the issue that we've seen. So, you know, I can't even name a second RCS client on Android right now outside of Google Messages. But I went ahead and asked DuckDuckGo's new AI feature, and apparently Samsung Messages, Textra, they say Signal and WhatsApp. I don't believe that's true. They just offer the features. So it sounds like Samsung and Textra might be some other things to consider. Chomp is here. I've never used these services, so I can't really guarantee what this is saying, but that's at least something to like check out, and hopefully we see more. I'd love to see an open source RCS client that we can get from something like F-Droid, the open source app store, and that has the native encryption features. Like, that is the future that I want to see. I want to see an open source RCS end-to-end encrypted app. Another question is timelines. When can we expect to realistically be using this? I think that if you're someone who's going to seek this out, right, like you're ready to go, you're going to find the messenger that already supports the spec, and you're able to get your friend to do the same thing. Who knows? I mean, I don't know how long it's going to take the standard to be actually implemented by a client, but this could roll out as soon as like the next year. But realistically, for like this to be just kind of language, like just what's normal to people and everyone kind of is used to using encrypted messaging through RCS, you know, we might be looking up to 5 years or more. So those are kind of the timelines I have in my head, but I have no idea. These are just my educated guesses. Another question I might get is like, what's the point of this? We already have Signal. We already have WhatsApp. This doesn't need to exist. And it's probably going to be worse privacy and security. And like, why? It doesn't matter. Like, and you know, I think it's really important to talk about some of the unique things about RCS that Signal and WhatsApp can't do. So one, I think people should have the right to communicate via open standards. I'm a Signal diehard. I think it's like one of the best, if not the best messenger out there overall in terms of balancing usability, privacy, security, etc. So when I say this, I don't mean it lightly, but I think everyone should still have the right to use a messenger without needing to create an account or enter any kind of unique ecosystem. Every messenger we recommend requires you to enter a new ecosystem. Better for worse with RCS is that it is an open standard. When you just simply have a phone number, and if someone else just simply has a phone number, you two can communicate via an open standard between two phone numbers. So as much as I love messengers like Signal, and I'm always going to recommend them over this for anyone who cares about privacy and security, I think they can both exist. I think we can have open standards that allow people to just communicate without needing to know how to do anything more than that, and we can still have things that go above that. And those two things can exist, and I'm really happy that the open standard side of things is getting this massive boost in protection. So yeah, I think this is fantastic. Universal end-to-end encryption brings significantly better privacy and security to all of you for everyday messaging. It also is going to enhance user experience, so you're going to get all the cool features that you're familiar with in the messenger. Standardization, I think, also fosters just a more secure and unified messaging ecosystem. So all we need now is for clients to step up and actually implement it. Some drawbacks again, I'm always kind of looking at the metadata side of things, and I'm guessing that there's going to be some kind of like things that we can nitpick about the spec and how good the encryption is going to be in this privacy, of course. And also, I think that it may impact the adoption of like dedicated ultra secure messaging apps, right? I talked about how it might be harder to sell people on things like Signal if there already is RCS with end-to-end encryption. But I think that issue existing is an inevitable drawback to something that's a net win. So the fact that things are getting closer to Signal shouldn't be seen as a drawback to getting people on Signal. It should be seen as a good thing that, you know, Signal is like the cool thing that Signal does is becoming more and more standardized. So that's all I have today. I really want to thank NoteSnook. They're an end-to-end encrypted notes provider, all open source. Check them out in the description. And I also want to thank redact.dev. They can go ahead and just clean up any of your digital identity for your main accounts online. And I want to thank all of our supporters. You can check them out down in the description, and you can check them out in the outro right now. If you want to learn more about messengers to use, I talk a lot more about other messengers in this over here. So go ahead and check that out, and I'll see you next time.